This vintage poster was saved from the jaws of decay so that it could be displayed in someone's home. We gave it a poster fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix. Today I'm going to linen back a poster of Che Guevara printed in the 1990s by Pyramid Publishers in England. The poster was in good condition, but the owner wanted it to be stronger so it would last longer. The entire process starts by stretching the screen. We stretch canvas on a big screen, but first we actually pull out the staples from the previous stretching when we mounted other posters before. We pull out the staples, we scrape off the excessive wheat paste, etc. This is a process we don't normally show you. Good job.
Yeah. One very large screen.
One very large screen ready for linen backing. Che Guevara was a prominent communist figure in the Cuban Revolution who went on to become a guerrilla leader in South America. He was executed by the Bolivian army in 1967 and has since been regarded as a martyred hero by generations of leftists worldwide. We need water to linen back so that we can mix the wheat paste. The wheat paste we use is similar to the wheat paste used in wallpaper hanging, but it is a finer grade. Even though this wheat paste is a finer grade of wheat paste, I'm going to strain it to make sure there are no lumps in it. Linen backing is a process where we take a vintage poster and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. This has the benefit of helping to make the poster stronger so it lasts longer. It also helps to neutralize the acids and provides a good base from which to do restoration or later on to frame or display. Once I've put the acid-free paper down on the screen, I pull it around to make sure that it's beginning to stretch out. And once it's stretched out, I roll it. I roll it to get rid of all the air pockets. This is a good process for most types of vintage posters, especially very, very old ones going back to the 1860s. But it also works for newer posters like this one, which was printed in 2009. Let's open the poster face up so I can see how it fits on the screen. Let's flip it around. It It's curling at the edges. Better dampen it. By dampening the poster, it will help to relax the paper and make it lie flat. The revolutionary leader was born Ernesto Guevara de la Serna on June 4, 1928 in Rosario, Argentina. Guevara, after completing his medical studies at the University of Buenos Aires, he became politically active, first in his native Argentina and then in neighboring Bolivia and Guatemala. In 1955, Guevara met Cuban revolutionary Fidel Castro and his brother Raul while in Mexico. The poster is expanding as we apply the wheat paste, but that's the easy part. Now, I have to flip the poster around. Voila! Because this poster is a glossy surface, we've got to be careful. The surface of glossy posters tends to be sensitive. The roller could leave a mark on it or cause some kind of jagged edge to appear. So you kind of want to push out the air pockets with a sponge first, which is not something we do with older posters. Did you know that Che Guevara has been the subject of a number of films, including The Motorcycle Diaries, which was based in part on his own account of his nine-month journey across South America in 1951 and 52, an experience that shaped his leftist beliefs. Guevara became part of Fidel Castro's efforts to overthrow the Batista government in Cuba. He served as a military advisor to Castro and led guerrilla troops in battles against Batista forces. When Castro took power in 1959, Guevara became in charge of La Cabaña Fortress prison. It is estimated that at least 144 people were executed on Guevara's extrajudicial orders during this time. Later, he became president of the Cuban National Bank and helped to shift the country's trade relations from the United States to the Soviet Union. Guevara addressed the United Nations General Assembly in 1964, where he also expressed support for the people of Puerto Rico. One year later, he was appointed Minister of Industry. Guevara left his post in 1965 to export the ideas of Cuba's revolution to other parts of the world. In 1966, he began to try to incite the people of Bolivia to rebel against their government, but had little success. With only a small guerrilla force to support his efforts, Guevara was captured and killed on October 9, 1967, in La Higuera by the Bolivian army, which had been aided by the CIA. Since his death, Guevara has become a legendary political figure. His name is often equated with rebellion, revolution, and socialism. Others, however, have remembered that he could be ruthless and ordered prisoners executed without trial in Cuba. Guevara's life continues to be a subject of great public interest and been explored and portrayed in numerous books and films, including The Motorcycle Diaries of 2004. We're going to let this poster dry for a few days before we cut it down and touch it up. You're going to go to your mother's and take a photograph. Good. Your mother lives in Alaska? And you're not going to see her until June of 2022. Well, okay, good then. In that case, once you get the poster, get back to me, tell me its size, tell me what kind of poster it is, tell me whether it's mounted on something, whether it needs to be relined or any of that stuff, and I'd be happy to help you then. All right? Okay. Take care. Down the poster and leaving 1 inch extra border. This way, when the poster goes to a framer, the framer has the option of trimming down that extra border to what he wants it to be to serve as overlap in the frame, depending on how much overlap he needs. So I generally leave 1 inch. In some cases, customers want more than 1 inch. In other cases, customers want me to trim it right down to the edge and leave them no border. There are a few areas of damage in the corners, very light wear. I'm going to burnish it and touch it up using water-based markers and pencils. My favorite aspect of this poster is that the colors are red, black, and white, which are the same colors as the Poster Fix logo. The colors of revolution? I don't know. They were
a strong combination of colors, but they were also used for the Gestapo uniforms.
One of the benefits of linen backing is that it makes the poster stronger so that it will last longer. It can be rolled. Well, there you have it, another artifact of history restored by Poster Fix. This is Chris. After 32 years of restoring vintage posters, I still look forward to seeing what you're going to send me. Thanks very much, and stay healthy.